Robin, you've written that Syria is the strategic center of the Middle East. How damaging has the fallout from its civil war been on its neighbors from Lebanon to Jordan and Iraq?
Oh, it's extraordinary. There's no event that has so changed the demographics and the security issues more than the Syrian crisis since the Palestinian crisis, you know, more than half a century ago. The numbers for little Lebanon, it's the equivalent of the United States taking in 80 million people, the equivalent of Britain taking in 16 million people. It's really changing the economic situation. It's created tremendous political instability, but that's happened even more in neighboring Turkey, in Jordan, where the second largest city is a Syrian refugee camp, Iraq, and even Egypt, which does not share a border.
And how about international policy to deal with this? Mm-hmm. In the U.S., President Obama said he's going to train 5,000 Syrian rebels this year and more in the years to come. But what difference is that going to make against President Assad's army?
Well, it's a numbers game. And the tragedy of Syria is that there is no military solution. And the administration is really trying to create a new militia that can put enough pressure on the Assad government to try to bring him to the negotiating table. The problem, as you point out, is that the regime has 70 to 100,000 fighters. ISIS has at least 20,000 fighters inside Syria. And when you talk about the number of forces that the Syrian rebels have, you're talking maybe, well, it's very small, and the new force is only going to be 5,000. The idea that this is going to change the military battlefield is an illusion.
How would you assess President Assad's position right now? Does it look like a stalemate to you?
Well, there's no end in sight to this war. Remember, Lebanon civil war went on for 15 years, and we're now only getting to year four of this war, and there's no end in sight. Assad is clearly weakened. His forces at their maximum were 300,000, so he's down a lot. There are many of his forces who are considered ghosts. They're not visible anywhere. They've either faded into the woodwork, gone home, defected. They're in prison because they were a suspect. So he has real limits on him, but he can't win this war. But it doesn't appear at the moment that anyone can.
Do you think the U.S. is more interested in the fight against ISIS than it is in deposing President Assad now?
There are two wars in Syria, and the United States is only engaged in one of them, and that is against the Islamic State. It wants to avoid at any cost getting enmeshed in what is the civil war against President Assad. That's a whole different set of problems that will be harder to sell at home and harder to wage as a war in the region.
And for Syria's refugees?
And in the meantime, you know, the World Food Program is running out of money to feed the 1.7 million Syrian refugees in Turkey, that they're just not the resources to take care of this tragedy anywhere in any country in the region.
Robin Wright, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.